Okay, so this is the fifth dream house that I made. I started making dream houses in SketchUp, I think around basically as soon as I installed it and started using it, in 2009 or so. And I started this one in middle school, so like seventh grade. And then I think most of the house was done by middle of 2014, and or middle of between 8th and 9th grade. And so right at, basically everything was done in middle school. And then this part here, and here, and the top story, and some of this here were done in high school, I think. And, you know, of course, minor details and whatnot. So it's all in all, it took about 2 years of time invested, I guess. 2 or 3 or so, yeah. And I don't know, it was kind of a transition time, I guess, for me. So I don't think that everything in it is representative of me now, but like it says a lot, I think, at the time. So I guess starting at the front, you know, mailbox, driveway, bench with the, so I wanted to, I've had fish for a while, and when I made this I had fish too, and I think I had just made a pond in our backyard. So I wanted to have a pond here, and I was trying to do koi or something like that, but like, I don't know, koi are hard to draw in SketchUp, so I just did like a battleship and stuff. And like, you know, there's a torpedo, and I guess there's a dud and a submarine and a sunken ship with like, it has stuff inside of it too that's not really important. You know, and a dead person on the lily pad, you know, it's just, you know, pretty authentic. And then to fill the pond up, there's a water pump. You know, solar panels, drainage, whatever. I guess I have like a mud room because I do a lot of dirty work outside, or I did at the time at least. I had like a forge and stuff, and I guess that's where we keep the shoes and stuff. So going into the house, so I was like, okay, TV, flat screen TVs are expensive and like they use a lot of material, so I don't think it's makes a lot of sense to get one. So I was like, okay, the future is probably going to be projectors, and I'm not quite right. I definitely wasn't right, but, you know, I got a projector and the TV remote, some, like, sketchy couch, and another fish tank. This one has beautiful two-dimensional fish. let's go in here and see the dining room area. So, I guess do like that. Yeah. So it's a little pole light and then lights surrounding the ceiling, and a light switch built into the table. And then a gong, because like in my parents' house, they would just like scream and shout so everyone goes to dinner. But like, I don't know, I feel like a gong would be more organized. And then, in retrospect, I feel like a bar would make more sense here, but, you know, this is cool. I don't know if you noticed, but there's crown molding on, like, most stuff in the house. I just like attention to detail and stuff. I'll try and point it out when I see something I remember. The stove, dishwasher, you know, kitchen sink, microwave, you know, coffee machine, oven, usual stuff. Not exactly the top tier oven. Same thing with the dishwasher. I mean, the refrigerator. This is another, like, you can do this on the internet or on the computer, but not in real life. So the pantry, I was like, I'm gonna go outside because it's easier to move the camera. So, I wanted to be tall and like a bunch of space, and it made sense to have like a ladder, I guess. So, like one of those old libraries and stuff where they have like multiple bookshelves you can access with ladders. And then I guess I'll show outside first, and then we can go down there. So, in the backyard, there is a garden, fire pit, and deck. So, air conditioner, just a grill, whatnot. And then my terrible tree, I like usually you just take a picture of a branch and then you just take the picture and put it all over the tree, but like I wanted to try and do it the hard way and it just didn't happen. So I copy pasted that terrible tree everywhere and I feel like, it's whatever. some detail on the door, I don't know. Okay, so let's go underground here and so, walk-in freezer, because like I don't know, most of my food that I eat is frozen food now, and like I don't think that was the case then, but like it was, a good foresight, I guess. So this makes sense for me, actually, one of the few people it would make sense for, and then a safe, because like of course I'm gonna be super rich and whatnot. And then I guess I should show the guest bathroom and the garage. Great, so go through the window. All right, so yeah, do the garage first. So this is literally all in the garage, recycling, and like, yeah, basically it's a pretty straightforward. And then I like did the thing for the garage door. Oh, went through the wall. Okay, so let's go to the bathroom. This is the first bathroom I did, so not super great, but it's there. So I have like a soap, hot cold, very crazy console for the sink with sandstone base or something. And then SketchUp doesn't do mirrors, so like I just wrote mirror so that it's clear. And I went to the door this time. There we go. So when I was actually working on this, my old computer wasn't this good, and like it would every time I moved the camera, all the textures would disappear, and it would take like a solid second for the textures to come back. So like this is kind of a neat mechanism I thought of because I don't like cleaning things, and I was just like, okay, let's just have it pump water, and you can mop it like that. And so there's a drain in the bottom, and it's also the fish tank water change thing. It could be automated. So, this is the stairwell, and it's a guest bedroom, I guess. So, kind of sketchy toilet and decent drain, I guess. Weird faucet. Even weirder sink. And so I'll just go through the wall. There's a closet to the side of this, but like, who cares? And I'll go into the other side closet. And then, also in retrospect, I think this should have been a Jack and Jill bathroom, but it's too late now. So let's sink here is cooler, I guess. Like, I don't know, I think it's neat. It's just weird that it's flat. Looks too thin. And the drain, I tried for these next couple of drains, I tried to keep them like somewhat interesting or something. So this one just is like a infinite spiral sort of thing, kind of. And of course, this bathroom doesn't have a toilet, which is kind of funny. And let's go outside because, so there's a hallway, which can I just like, yeah, I'll do in here. The hallway does not go to the end, and I think my plan was to have like a balcony or something like that, and I never got around to it. But you can kind of see here at least how I did the molding, the kind of molding and stuff for the ceilings and floors. It's just I do the design on the side of it there, and then I just extrude it all the way around the floor. So my bedroom. Okay, so light. Ceiling fan. And I had more pictures at some point in time, but they disappeared. No clue what happened. Some incense and candles for decoration, not to actually use, like most people. And then my thinking on this was like, okay, this is what I thought the future of computing would look like, just a box with some combining cables which go to a wireless receiver. And I honestly have no clue what this is anymore. And this is your mouse, this is what you have instead of a keyboard. And like, I hadn't gotten into programming yet, but like, now that I write code, I know this is not good. but anyway, or maybe this was to track your fingers and whatnot. So this is just me screwing around with the computer. It's 2014 date. And this closet area thing here, it goes into the stairwell, and that space, like if you want to put like a Christmas tree or I have no clue what you'd put in there, but it's there. Just didn't want to make the bathroom huge and oddly shaped. Where did I go? That's the bathroom. Okay. Sinks here also kind of sketch, but this one has a joystick. And then the shower and bath, and this one has a toilet paper roll holder. I think this is the only room, only one in the building, but minor details. The important detail is the drains, right? So they're one of those kind of fractal looking drains. Let's see. And this is, of course, a north-facing window, so it won't get much sun, and it's tiny, so like, this is basically cave bedroom, which is ideal, I think. So, I guess there could have been a balcony here or whatever, but it doesn't matter. So I guess we can go to the next floor. I'm not going to go through the inside here, you can see. But this is supposed to be kind of like a working area, home office sort of thing. So this is my setup. Who needs a mouse? It's just a keyboard. And this is Pavre. And like, I have actually written Pavre by hand to make stuff, but like, this is before I did that. So like, I just did an LED, and this was like my profile picture and a bunch of stuff for a while. So that was kind of significant for me. And then just like random screenshots from 2015, like freshman year of high school, because that's about when I made this. And, washing room, very basic looking stuff. And I have no clue what else I was planning to put in there, but it's probably not important. Probably a storage or whatever. So that's the house. There's solar panels, drainage, the garden and whatnot. I guess let's go into the rest of it. So here's like a pond lake thing. My grandfather has a pond on his property, and I thought that was cool and wanted to kind of emulate that. But unlike his is just a beaver dam basically, but it's big because it was also a mill at some point. But I put like an actual proper dam for electricity, and like I wanted to have like a full instrument panel in here, but like it's a lot, and I wasn't creative enough to come up with like useless dials and whatnot, what they might be possibly used for. So I didn't quite finish that. And then like I was kind of into geology and stuff at the time, and so I made like what I thought was a reasonable geologic sequence, but like I don't think it is anymore. Just by the these would be like massive maybe. And yeah, so of course there's a fire next to the coal mine. That's a great idea. And at some point I had a shovel in there, but it got deleted or whatever. I kept having so many different copies of this project on whatever computer I was working on at the time. Just didn't go down. So like, anyway, I just nerded out on the geology with the, like, what is it called? What is it actually composed of? So here I actually had a mine on my parents' old property, and it was very small. But like my plan was something along these lines, right? Dig a shaft down and then go horizontal once you hit bedrock. But like I didn't quite get that far, of course. But anyway, this is like a generator room, so I had like coal or something here, and the plan was to make methanol, so like wood gas. And I did coal because it's easier, but like obviously wood or charcoal or whatever would be better. And that wood gas goes to the generator here, which is like an 8-cylinder engine. It's electric generator. And like there was a bunch of like safety stuff, so like smoke alarm, and then the air pump to stop the flow, smother it out if you have to, and then like this extreme security door with a, see if I can, yeah, enter password, the very elaborate opening mechanism. And then here, this is the only part of this thing that actually, and I went into the smokestack, that actually came to me in a dream. So in the dream there was like a couch or something here, and I was asleep on that, and I kind of woke up and the waterfall and whatnot, and there was actually a skylight in this area here. And I went over here and I was messing with this metal rod, and I pulled it out and it was molten at the end. So I had just been doing a lot of blacksmithing stuff, and that kind of had a recurring dream, and I was like, okay, I should build this. So pantry, little kitchen area, old home landline phone because cell phones don't work underground. And a stove, it's like a hibachi stove, I guess. And this shower was actually in the dream too. Anyway, coal room, and like this is supposed to be like a utility closet for cleaning supplies and whatnot, and then sink and bathroom and stuff. So this is like, I feel like once I got to this part of the house, I was like, had a better grasp of like how to use the software and whatnot. So anyway, I made a chemistry lab too. And it's got your essentials, it's got your periodic table, fume hood, some storage closets, which could have been refrigerated, who knows? Random black box, because who doesn't want one of those? And a sink of some sort. So, yeah. It's the mine. And I had I had plans for like an electronics thing, electronics lab that I would go in here, but like, you know, obviously that didn't happen. And what else do I have? Yeah, smokestack for the coal fire under there. Yeah, I guess that's about it. Not too much else. It just took a long time of tedious clicking and dragging things and whatnot. So, yeah, I guess I'll stop.